Okay, I do apologize for the sound. This is going to be a two-day video. Jerry Rosa's DreamWorks has been trying to find pore filler, and I'm going to try something, an experiment. I am using tried and true varnish oil. I've got some walnut, Padauk, and mahogany, ribbon strap mahogany. I'm just going to take some 600 grit sandpaper. I've sanded it to 220 grit. And I'm just going to try and sand this in. And this is kind of I know this is a similar trick to what they do with French polish, where they use a thin shellac with a pumice of some sort of abrasive stone on a rag to fill pores. So that's what I'm going to try to do with this. And I'm going to try to do this very quick because I don't know how well my phone's going to want to behave itself to do this. Basically, what I'm going to do is just hit it with this 600 grit with this varnish oil and basically try to build a slurry. I don't know how well this is coming across on camera. You can kind of see there's a little bit of a slurry building, and hopefully that will fill the pores. And then I'll let it set until tomorrow and come back and just hit it again with the 220. And when I do that, I'll do a follow-up video just to show what it looks like. And I'm going to try to get a different part of the sandpaper I'm using. It's that little amount, and that's probably far too much for what I'm using this on. But that was the walnut. This is the Padauk, and this is the guitar that Jerry Rosa was working on. Was a now I hope I'm getting your name right. I'm bad with names, and I'm sorry if I'm not. If I'm wrong with your name, I'm sorry. Don't be too upset with me. You can kind of see the slurry I'm building with the 600 grit sandpaper. And again, I'm not sure with lighting how well this is coming across, but it looks to be doing something. This paste is doing something to fill the pores, and it's, I don't know how well it's going to work on the Padauk because it's such a porous nature. I also don't know how it's going to work because this is has true boiled linseed oil, not the metal dryers, and I don't know how well it's going to work with the oils in the Padauk, because it's a fairly oily wood for anyone who's not familiar with it. A lot of the rosewood type woods can be a bit of a pain to work with certain finishes just because of that. Hopefully when I do the grand reveal, I'll think to have some better lighting or something where it can, hopefully I'll be able to position it to focus. I'm going to move my sandpaper along again. And this is the only thing I have that's really thin is ribbon strap mahogany. And this is going to come in handy because I want to see if it will bleed through or not. I've had some issues with that in previous tests on ribbon strap mahogany, whatever I'm using to fill, well, on thinner stuff like this, basically backer side material, which, I mean, that's how thin it is. Sometimes it really wants to bleed through to the other side, and you get these little, basically, watermarks. And it definitely is soaking. I can tell a difference between it in the Padauk. The Padauk, that however much I put on there was enough to do it. With this, it's soaking it up. It's so you can tell the nature of the wood that way. It's not just kind of sitting on top mixing with the dust and working in. It's you get the sensation that it is actually being soaked into the wood. I don't know how well this is. Like I said, it's not. I'm looking at it through my phone, which is all I have to record on right now, and it looks like crap. And I'm pretty sure if I just had some better lighting in this particular little corner, it would be more pronounced. You could see it a little bit better. I'm going to get just a touch more. I'm not 100% satisfied, and I might do that with the Duke, just add a little touch more, but this might be my fatal flaw. As a matter of fact, I don't know if you see that right there. I think is where it's trying to bleed through. I don't think that might be a little bit there too, but it'll be interesting to see how this turns out. Like I said, it looks nice. I mean, again, it's not really, my attempts at photography is not doing it justice because of lack of lighting, but it looks nice enough. As the old saying goes, the proof is in the pudding, and I don't think the Paduke is going to, some of the deeper cracks in the Paduke will be filled. I could be wrong. It definitely is not coming across well, but that's what I've got so far. Yeah, just a tiny bit. I really want this to work. Just because it'd be nice to find to be the one that found a good solution. I doubt it will, but you know, I doubt I'll be the one because he's been at it probably building instruments about as long as I've been alive, maybe longer, and he ain't found it yet. So if he ain't found it, what's the chances I'm going to find it? And it might be, I mean, there's definitely a slurry and a half on it. Like this Paduke, I'm just touching it up a little bit more. There's a thick slurry. You can kind of see where it's blobbed up right there. Maybe some type of like squeegee action to kind of catty corner would help. Why not try a little bit more on the walnut? Like I said, this may not be necessarily practical, but on a whole instrument, this is just test wood to see if it'll even work. Because I said I was going to do this, try something like this, but okay, it looks fairly good to me, but what I'll do, I still think there's a few low spots in it. Yeah, I think it's really wanting to bleed through on the mahogany. I'm going to just let it sit overnight. Now I can come back tomorrow, and like I said, I'll scuff it with some 220 and see how it turns out. Later.